Hello friends, welcome back. Thank you for your support. Today's video is preparing very delicious mouth-watering banana halwa. In a minutes of time we can prepare at home, very easy. Check out the description box for more information about the recipe. Here I'm using two bananas which is already fully ripe. I'm gonna grind the banana in a mixer jar. You can use your type of blender to grind it. So grind it as a puree, no need to add milk, no need to add water. We only want banana to be grinded. So once it is grinded, serve in a bowl. So this is the consistency we are expecting after grinding. Now let's go for a cooking process. I'm adding 2 tablespoons of ghee. Once ghee is melted, you can add almond, cashews and also a little sesame seeds. Fry it in a very low flame for 1 minute or until it gets kind of golden color. This cashews and also almond with the sesame seeds, it really gives very good crunch when you are eating banana halwa. Gently remove it and keep it aside. So for the same ghee, we gonna add banana puree. So friends, while here we need to cook banana with the ghee, you can use the medium flame. Keep cooking it for 2 to 3 minutes. Friends, if you are watching my videos for the first time, don't forget to subscribe the channel. Also share the video with your friends and family members. Then you can see the banana puree is getting thick and also getting along with the ghee. You can add some ghee. If you think that banana puree is getting sticking to the pan, then you can add little ghee again. Once this banana puree is getting slightly thick, we gonna add sugar. So here you can increase or decrease the sugar quantity as per the banana quantity, and also I'm adding little turmeric. So start cooking it. So we need to cook this both mixture like 5 minutes. After 5 minutes of cooking in a medium flame, banana halwa consistency has ready. However, we have to mix the dry fruits and we still have to cook it for another 1 to 2 minutes in a low flame. So once the banana halwa is done, you can see it's perfectly non-sticky, and also as per the consistency, like if you are expecting very thin soft consistency, then you can remove it. If you think that you want little kind of medium hard, then you can cook it for another 1 minute until it becomes slightly hard. Finally, don't forget to add elaichi powder. It adds really very good fragrance and also the final taste for the banana halwa. This is the perfect consistency. Once banana halwa is done, it almost shrinks to 1/4 quantity. Gently place it in a vessel or the plate. I'm just leveling up here sideways to look better and also to cut easily. You can cut it, and also since it is cooked, it will be easy to cut as well. This is how it looks like. So tasty and also superb, easy to make at home. Do try, you will like it for sure. Let's check out today's motivation. Very short but very true. Your nature is your future. Friends, I hope you will like this video. If you like it, don't forget to subscribe the channel. See you again. Bye-bye.